So what is binder jetting? The way it works is you're gonna lay a layer of powder, in this case, roughly 42 microns thick. And then after you lay that layer of powder, you selectively deposit binder in the cross section of your part. And we'll continue that over and over until we build up the entire Z height of the components. Once we've printed, we'll go through a curing step, which heat activates the binder. Basically, it locks all the metal powder into place. After that, we'll go through a depowdering step. So we can check that out over here. During depowdering, we're gonna blow off all the loose powder on the components. Then we vacuum that up to be recycled and reused in future prints. And when they're done with depowdering, it reveals like a green geometry. And a green geometry is about 20% oversize in every direction. We can then take that to the furnace for sintering. Sintering is a thermal process where basically we heat the parts up to just below their melting temperature. The parts will actually densify in every direction and out comes a fully dense metal part. It's about a 20-hour cycle. The first segment, we remove the binders from the part. The next segment, we ramp up to near top temperature and hold for a prescribed amount of time. The parts will shrink roughly 20% in each direction, and then we'll cool down. At that point, the parts are ready for their next operation. A lot will ship as is, but some of them will go out for post-heat treatments. Some of them will go out for different surface coatings like chrome plating or PVD coating or Cerakoting. And some of the parts will go on to polishing.